Are you ready to take your photography to the next level? Even if you're just taking photos with your smartphone, there are still opportunities to make the photo stand out from the already predetermined fabric settings. Every brand or model has, let's call it, a predetermined setting on how the camera thinks the framing or exposure should look like. This goes both for cameras and smartphones with their computerized processing. Photography can seem intimidating if you want to step outside those boundaries, but it doesn't have to be. In this series, I will try to explain the basics in my own way so that you in no time feel comfortable to take your camera or smartphone into manual settings and start taking photos in your own creative style. Are you ready? Sit back, grab a coffee, relax, and I will explain. The first thing we have to do is to set the camera or smartphone in manual mode. The Samsung phone I know has a pro mode, and they also have an Export RAW app that's pretty good. And for iPhone, I'm not sure what it's called. Maybe it's just manual mode. If you know, please comment below. When you go into this mode, you take away the camera's way of guessing how the composition should be exposed, focused, and so on. With the smartphone, there is a built-in artificial intelligence that guesses the exposure and focus for you. The focus in both smartphone and cameras are usually pretty good, so in most situations that can actually be in autofocus mode. I will get back how you can use focus creatively in a later episode, but first let's talk about exposure. Exposure is how much light that is allowed to enter through your camera lens and hit the sensor, or let's call it the receiver of what we are looking at with our eyes. You can control the exposure through three different setting options, at least you can with cameras. With smartphones, one option might be automatic. We got ISO, we got aperture, and we got shutter speed. Shutter speed controls how long the lens is open, and the ISO controls the light sensitivity of your camera. Lastly, aperture controls the amount of light that passes through your lens. Aperture also gives you another creative option, and that is depth of field. A shallow depth of field will give you a blurry background, that means a low f-number as it's called, while a deep depth of field, a higher f-number, will keep everything in focus. The smaller aperture f-number, the more shallow depth of field, the higher aperture f-number, the more deep depth of field you'll get. This option might be restricted in the manual settings on smartphones. I know it is on Samsung. You can only choose which aperture lens to use and then control the other options to adjust to your creative style. ISO refers to the sensitivity of the camera's image sensor to light. It is represented by a numerical value such as ISO 100, ISO 200, ISO 400, and so on. The higher ISO number means the camera sensor is more sensitive to light. It gives you a tool for shooting in low light conditions, but can also result in more noise or graininess in the image. Lower ISO number means the camera sensor is less sensitive to light, which is suitable for shooting in bright conditions like today, and typically produces less noise or graininess in the image. So, here is an important tip. Always try to keep the ISO as low as possible and adjust the other options accordingly. But there are some situations where you need to use the higher ISO number. If you don't, it can actually make or break your photo. And lastly, we have the shutter speed. In Samsung, I know it's called speed, not sure for the iPhone. If you know, comment below so I can learn it as well. Shutter speed refers to the amount of time that the camera's shutter stays open when you are taking your photo. It is measured in fractions of a second, and it determines how long the camera sensor is exposed to light. A faster shutter speed, such as 1,000th of a second, is used to freeze motion or capture fast-moving objects like sports, racing cars, and so on. Slower shutter speed, such as 1/30th of a second, allows more light to enter the camera and is used for capturing low light scenes, but it might result in blurry images if the camera or subject moves during the exposure. So here it can be smart to use a tripod. I'll get back to that in a later episode when I talk about night photography. So all of these options is a way to control your exposure, but also has another effect, and it depends on what your creative idea for the photo is and how the situation are. Fast moving objects or an object that you want to highlight, put in focus, and so on. That was it, the first episode. I hope you liked it and that it made some kind of understandable sense to you. If you liked the video, I would really appreciate if you subscribe if you haven't done it already. And remember the notification option there. You have to manually set it to all notifications. YouTube by default has set it to an option that does not give notifications when I upload new videos in this series. So please set that option to all. It's next to subscribe. Maybe share my video with some friends, help me spread the video and this series that I'm making, and hit the like button, thumbs up. These things helps the algorithm to understand that this video was maybe an okay video to watch. Finally, remember, photography is all about experimenting and finding what works for you. So don't be afraid to try new things, push yourself out of your comfort zone, and so on. With this basic tip, I believe that you'll be way on your way, it's a lot of talking here, be well on your way to take amazing photos in your own creative style. That's it. My name is Chris. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Now I'm tired. Bye-bye.